Welcome everybody here to your coverage of the Bigpoint Battle. I am TobiWan, bringing your English live stream, one of actually multiple streams you can choose from. Go over to bigpoint-battle.com and you'll find all the details over there. As far as your JD live streams, you've got both the red and the blue fired up today. And over here on the red live stream, we're going to start off with FR. We're censoring their name. They are FR going up against Team Empire. You're probably going to know their names a lot better once we get ourselves right here into the draft. Luckily, I am not alone because I know we're a little bit behind as far as me being behind, but the man who's always on time is my co-caster, the Capitalist. Welcome to the broadcast, man.
Oh, thanks for having me, and this is a pleasant little surprise for me. I didn't know who we were going to be casting.
You're expecting like this team to be like randoms, like FR to be randoms, and I was like, wait, hang on, is that Shafiq? Is that like Jotam? Is that Zizu? Is it like, is this actually a good team?
Yeah, I was like, this is my good friend Stampa and Shafiq, and exactly, I was like, oh, nice. Looks like we actually are going to have a pretty good game here.
Yeah. Hey, man, I only choose the best games I can possibly get out of the first round. Because you always, like, you're shooting fish in a barrel sometimes, and, like, you just, like, you wonder where all the fish are when you do, like, these kind of, like, open qualifiers into a cup series, and all of a sudden you basically hit the mother load. And for me, this one's pretty close to it. Empire, who've been playing really well of late. I kind of picked this match to start with just because I wanted to watch Team Empire. And then I saw who they're up against. Like, you know what? There's no way we can evade this game. 10 seconds remaining.
Yeah, it's definitely not the Team Empire that we have seen from, you know, a month or even 2 months ago where they were just floundering and losing absolutely everybody. They've really made some good changes. Some recent additions to their team have become a much stronger team. And I think that they're actually going to be soon on one of those top, you know, one of those top European teams here in the next few months. So definitely going to keep an eye on them. Visage, Nature's Prophet, picked up by Team Empire. Alchemist, Nyx Assassin, and now the Weaver was picked up by FR. So right now we've already got the cores being picked up by FR. Alchemist, Carry Alchemist, and Weaver, unless they want to go that sort of support Alchemist and throw us for a loop here. But I'm guessing this is going to be an aggressive tri lane with a Weaver in the solo safe lane, but they still have plenty of options.
Yeah. Actually, let's run through the entire thing, man. Did you do...
I didn't do bands.
You didn't do bands. You didn't do no. bands. Because at least
that's what I didn't do.
Just the picks. Fantastic, man. Fantastic. Cap.
Yes.
This isn't going to be how today is. What you say means the world to me.
What?
5 seconds. I'm sorry. I literally was leaving home like an hour early today. I was going to have everything prepared, everything done. I had to take care of a couple little things over on my side while you were talking about that first little bit. So I'm sorry, Capitalist. I'm sorry. This happened again.
Of course. Well, I'm expecting it, Toby.
No. You should expect better. You deserve better, Cap. You deserve better. So do the 800 people who are currently watching this live stream, because right now we're doing a fun stream today. oh God. Okay. Let's finish up our draft, man. So low druid. Poor little bastard, gonna be the last one to be banned out. We're taking out, well, we got off laners with the Queen of Pain also being removed. OD, happy not to see him inside the pool. At the same time, happy not to see the Wisp or the Anti-Mage inside the pool. And happy that no one decided to go for the cancel answer. Just to throw that one out there after we had the draft of no fun yesterday. Which actually turned out to be a lot of fun once Timbersaw got picked up. But Clockwork, Bane, Prophet, Visage. They got a lot of burst damage. Just coming out from the Bane as well as the Visage. And then you add a Prophet ulti into the mix of that. And the control from Clockwork. The only thing I'm missing from Team Empire is massive physical DPS. But they got enough lockdown that... Actually, with the Bane's Fiend's Grip, they should have enough lockdown. But because Rubik's on the field, I'm a little bit worried. They cannot control that Weaver enough. But at the same time, Weaver requires, as always, a large amount of farm and space to do such a thing. But in this scenario, he's going to be forced to an offlaner unless Alchemist is going to go into that solo mid role, which is also highly doubtful. Where you run a Nyx and Rubik just farming up in the bottom lane, farming up levels, doing pull-throughs, that old standard kind of shizzle, and Team Empire. Their only choice right now is if they want to go head-to-head with the defensive tri lane or not. If you're going to throw Clockwork up on that top lane to go one-on-one with the Weaver, and then you put, well, that would put Profit into the middle lane in that scenario. I'm not quite sure exactly where Team Empire would end up with these players if Light of Heaven will take their Clockwork Soul up against the Weaver. I kind of like to see that option.
Yeah, and looks like FR is going to go for that. This has been getting very, very common, this sort of dual tanky strategy where both of these heroes, Dragonite and Alchemist, very strong mid-game heroes, provide some decent amounts in the laning phase. Alchemist with his stun, and then Dragonite just being able to spam Breathe Fire in that mid lane. They go into the mid-game, they're pretty tanky, they're hard to shut down from being able to farm, and if they go into team fights, they have their own, they add a lot to them. And then late-game, they don't fall off significantly hard, so combined, the two of them, you add in a Weaver as well, a heavy, heavy physical damage dealer as we start going into the late game. A hero who relies heavily on mobility and then just pure, pure damage. You can take this pretty late and not be able to have to fear the Spectre. So this is going to be one of those Empires going to have to get that Spectre, that early initial amount of farm, maybe even that build that we saw yesterday. Something that is just pure stats early on, rely on the Desolate to be able to provide you a lot of damage, just get some basic survivability items, and then just try and fight. Try and fight as soon as possible, get some sort of lead, and take some towers, back up, farm up a little bit more, and then just go straight for the throat, because you know you don't want to be going up against a 3-core in the late game.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. There's no way you want to go up against that. Let's run through our lineups for where the players are going to be. So up on this top lane, have they actually changed the names around here? Because I'm pretty sure Huni...
Yes.
that was somebody else before we started this.
I think that was... That was the person that I had no idea who that was. I recognize all four of these names.
I will let Hjort try and work out who the hell that one is as he checks it. Sunlight, a little bit troll for him. Pick up and throw down, but didn't pull him inwards. Could have possibly pulled him in. Shikuji threw a little of extra damage. Could have caused a lot of damage to that Visage right there when Sunlight got caught out, but they decided against it.
Yeah, I'm a little bit surprised that they didn't choose to run the Alchemist here in this lane, but Alchemist going up against a Bane, first of all, you're going to have to deal with that Enfeeble. As a melee hero, it's very easy just to get Enfeeble harassed and not be able to pick up much CS, and as well as the fact that his Unstable Concoction, which he relies on so heavily in these tri-lanes, can be just completely destroyed by an easy Bane sleep. Being able to get in that 1 second of invulnerability will completely save your ally, so they're going to go ahead and run it up against the Nature's Prophet. Either way, no matter what they ran up against this tri-lane, the tri-lane should do fairly well, and this solo should do fairly well as well. I mean, Weaver would absolutely destroy a Furion in his safe lane, but Alchemist should be able to farm up decently well and not be able to deal with too much harassment.
Yeah. He'll just tank it up, and hopefully he gets to level 6 at some decent point, and then he'll have his regeneration. Nothing's really going to stop him then. I'm not liking this for Jotam, though, up on the top lane. It's this Enfeeble. He's got very minimal damage. He basically has to rely on Shikuchi to actually get last hits here, because Blow Your Brain just does this. Comes in close, gets the last hit off, and also knows to Blow Your Brain. Like, he's going up against 3 heroes in one lane, and now he only now just levels up Dispersion. He could have had that at the very, very start, realizing the pull's already happening from Sunlight as well as FNG. So now he'll level up the Dispersion, but he waited a very long time for that one. Could have possibly reflected some of the damage back, but didn't look like, well, any of the guys from FR want to even contest him on that top lane.
Yeah, they're playing extremely passive in this lane. Even though the Weaver tri-lanes are pretty good, they seem to be playing very, very scared, just starting from the very beginning where they threw the Visage away from them rather than into them.
Sorry, just realized Shafiq and Scandal are basically throwing each other at themselves.
Yeah, this middle lane, Dragonite should be able to do fairly well, at least be able to pick up a decent amount of CS and just spam out that Breathe Fire. Once he hits level 5, Clockwork's going to feel in that harassment quite a bit.
Is Sunlight and FNG, like, it almost feels like this top lane, the two supports for the Radiant side are waiting for Team Empire to initiate. And the two supports on Empire side are waiting for the levels to come and almost waiting for the initiation to come from FR. But neither supports are wanting to make that move yet until somebody gets too low on life and they think it's a good opportunity to go.
Well, they can't afford to sit around for too long because Empire does have access to the poll since they countered it. And they're getting in that extra experience. And you let that go on for too long, and all of a sudden you attempt to force a fight. And they have that extra level on you, and that could be huge.
Oh, there's your stun. So maybe not for too much longer. Shikuchi through. There's already that Enfeeble, and the nuke flying so hard over to Stomper. He gets himself to 9 up to one of the neutrals. Nicely moved down. Jotam as well, going to try and retreat out. 1 second for the Shikuchi, and then with the Grave Chill, movement speed too much. Sunlight can't hold him there. And Team Empire going to feel a little bit robbed by that Ursa. Or Hellbear.
Yeah, that was really unfortunate that they stacked their stuns like that. If they'd been able to chain their stuns a lot better, they might have had an opportunity to get that kill.
First game of the day. It takes time to warm up.
Then again, Light of Heaven is already feeling that harassment from Acid Spray. I was expecting maybe just a complete farming build coming out from this Alchemist, but instead he's choosing to max Acid Spray, or at least get a couple levels on it early, and Light of Heaven's feeling that harassment. It's just such a huge AoE that he has to be in the, he has to be in that Acid in order to get CS.
Shafiq and Scantler going at it again. Inside the cogs, actually looks like Shafiq with that extra stick charges. He got enough damage, Scandal. Down 26 life points. Just able to get away. And again, we're going to watch Sunlight. A little bit out of position here. But Jotam, he's too busy dealing with the Hellbears. But now the sun will go. FNG picked up with the telekinesis. Throw him back down again. The sun over to blow your brain. He's low on life. And they actually get the first blood. But it was Bane killing up the Nyx Assassin before Weaver could finish up the Bane. And with the Soul Assumption, blow your brain needs one more attack. Now he needs a little bit more after the healing salve will pop off. Jotam still goes Shikuchi to get himself away in 1 second time, and that'll actually get a kill over to Sunlight, giving him a double kill, in fact. Not worth it when they lose off from that, actually, Jotam, he overstayed his welcome here. That Desolate's really going to work. It's a good thing Stomper came in, but blow your brain, able to get that kill. Whoa, FNG! He came in to give him a healing sound, but almost blocked him into death. Now the dagger to fly down, and that'll actually get a double kill for blow your brain. The Nightmare allows for the easy setup, and there was no running away from that one.
Yeah, great potion save there by Blow Your Brain. That last hit coming out from the Rubik was going to be able to finish him off, and that would have been a good trade for them at that point in time. But aggressive tri-lane, a complete wipe for a complete wipe, I would completely take that. But unfortunately, the potion save, and then he was able to get off the dagger after that, resulting in Rubik's death. Small little plays can make a big deal. Oh, Scandal's going to jump in on middle. Sharfeek, he's going to go down here. He's completely locked in the cogs. Oh, the bottle comes in at the right time. He's actually going to be able to get out and turn around and continue his breathe fire harassment.
Nothing like having some good stick charges. Yeah. Also, guys, I apologize. I realize the colors are incorrect for this one. So let me just change that around for you. So now everything looks fine again. My bad. I changed it for some of the other overlays, but didn't update this one. So the game should be back to a visible level as opposed to being in the dark and gloomy ages.
I was wondering why that changed. Like, why? I don't know. Why would Toby mess with the brightness?
I don't know why it changed, man. Seriously, it's something where, like, the settings never, ever changed, and all of a sudden, everything just looks so much darker. I'm like, I never changed this. I'm guessing that there was something which changed in the setup, but I don't know what the hell it was. So, yeah. I've worked out the fix, and the fix has now been applied.
Well, Sharfeek's going to be happy about this one. Already chasing the clockwork away, surviving earlier, and now he's picking up a regen. He's going to stun him, throw down another breathe fire, and he doesn't care. Just do some harassment. And Scandal's going to be kicked out of lane here just because the Bottle Crow may not even be enough if he sticks around and gets harassed by that breathe fire. And in fact, he's actually going to go bottom. Alchemist has his ultimate down. This is actually really good communication here by Light of Heaven. He said that the Alchemist's ultimate was going to be on cooldown for a while, and that Clockwork's going to take that opportunity to see if they can get a gank. Unfortunately, there's just as good communication coming out the Dragonite that Clockwork was missing.
Yeah, which means Alchemist just moves back. He even pops his Chemical Rage just as a precautionary measure. He would have seen the Clockwork go past Light of Heaven and back again. Also, that's two Light of Heaven's gold. He's got a lot of money up his sleeve, sitting at 1,000. I was wondering if he's going to go into phase boots or not, but judging by the fact that he hasn't spent that 1,000 gold means he's not finishing up treads, which means he is going to go straight into that Hand of Midas build. Middle lane, Scandal's about to get ganked up. Zizou as well as Stomper. They're already on their way in looking for Scandal. But such a difficult hero to try and initiate in on, especially when he hides under the tower like this. It's just the wrong timing to come when Shafiq pushes the creep wave aggro underneath the tier 1 tower. It means Scanner will never come out, and your only option then is to loop around the back end.
That's a very dangerous place to be. When it's a tanky hero like Clockwork that you're ganking that's going to survive for a while, you're going to have teleports come in, you could easily pay for it.
Well, looks like Scandal finally came out a little bit too far. And Spectre going to ulti out for this one with the Prophet ulti as well. Is he looking for a kill elsewhere? Nope, Blow Your Brain just does it because he thought he could help out the Clockwork, but it was already too late.
Maybe a bit of a delayed reaction. Also had his ultimate at top. Maybe he was trying to track the Weaver, because if they get that Bane ultimate on the Weaver, obviously he's completely dead.
Oh yeah.
But
yeah. But Weaver's up here solo, and he was also a little bit higher. He was actually further up the lane on the other side of the Empire line. And now Shafiq doing what DKs do best when they're in their ultimate form, bringing down tier 1 towers. This is gonna be so difficult to stop. The fortification is the only thing they're thinking about. FNG. He does have that ultimate, but with Stomper right behind him, there is no level 6 up on him, so that's at least okay. But with that stun and the telekinesis, they can both break it. Scanner gonna jump in. He wanna pop up the cogs, get a little bit more space. The Shafiq, when he's got a haste rune, he'll find all the space in the world. And now it will be Empire just not to deny that tier 1 tower in mid.
Yeah, and Bane's gonna smoke up, he's gonna head bottom. They really wanna stop this Alchemist from free farming. They know that he's got some early levels in Grievous Greed. They can't let him just continue to farm up against the Furion, because obviously Furion, he's really good at harassment, being able to summon the trees and everything, but a tanky hero like Alchemist, especially once he hits level 6, he just doesn't care. He just takes the harassment and just keeps on picking up that CS. So they're going to need some rotations, and FNG is going to be it, trying to use his ultimate. And it's a good time, too. Alchemist just popped his ultimate, and it's going to be going on cooldown here in a couple seconds.
Got some support coming to the top lane. Stomper and DK up here with Jotam. Dragon form in 3 seconds time, and they're bringing in more. Nyx Assassin as well on the way in. But Empire have got an Observer Ward, watching this very, very closely. So they will not be caught by surprise. That's why I believe Brain and Sunlight will not leave this tower. At the same time, Scandal's getting himself some free space in the middle lane. FNG, he'd love to get that ulti off, but the problem is, if he does so, like, he's got to come in the range of the Alchemist's tower and the acid spray like this. I don't know if you also noticed too, Light of Heaven's large amount of denies. Most of those have actually been his trees. He's been sending him into the acid spray to try and fight as much as they can, pull them back out and just denies them off. Doesn't want to give anything extra to that, but that's also the reason why the experience difference isn't really that much between the Alchemist as well as the Prophet. Courier delivered in some. Rocket for Scandal. He's got DD Rune activated. Tower will go down. Ulti's himself up. Looking for the cogs. Didn't get them off in time. Got stunned up by Shafiq. But in comes Blow Your Brain. Ulti up. He's searching for Zizu. And Light of Heaven. Nice TP into the corner on the other side of the tree line. Now Scandal moves over towards Jotam. He can't see him, however. Now he can. Soul Assumption. Time lapse manages to evade most of that as well as the damage. But it's still not going to stop the double kill coming the way there of the Weaver. But it is a 2-for-2 trade off here.
Yeah, I'm picking up the tower as well. I think that's definitely going to be worth it for them. Especially since it's Empire who wants to be able to keep up their tier 1s. They can't give away that early gold. Otherwise, you're going to see these three different cores being able to stop the Spectre when they go into team fights.
He's giving a shot for the Courier. He's going to get vision of it too. Oh, wow. And that's the Courier. No! Oh, nighttime be damned. He couldn't see it. Just over the tree line, he couldn't see it. Or if he did, he didn't attack fast enough.
Yeah, that's just so unfortunate. Right now, gold lead is actually very, very minimal. Same goes with experience. This is a very close game. A very, very close game. There's a slight kill lead for Empire, but that's sort of made up by the fact that Alchemist's Grievous Greed is free farming. And, even that, it's still Furion has the highest gold per minute in this game. Light of Heaven, with that Wrath of Nature and then the Midas as well, he's actually out farming the Alchemist.
Well, looks like we got some fun here. Shafiq caught in the bottom rune. Clockwork Goblin able to bring him down. Light of Heaven also TP'd in to give a little bit of help there. And that might be an indication they want to try and push on this bottom tower as well. It's got a hand of Midas that's currently off cooldown. I would like to see that change, Light. There we go. Make sure that thing's always on, off cooldown. On cooldown. He's up to 2k gold, man. He's got a lot of money. Like, in comparison right now to what we've got on the Alchemist, like, Alchemist hasn't even finished up his Shadow Blade just yet, but we're going to see Light of Heaven building into his next item already. I'm wondering, too, if it's going to be the mech or not, because FNG as well as Sunlight are nowhere near having that mech up and running. Now bottom lane, Light of Heaven. He's going to get ganked on. So Concoction was already there, Dragon Tail as well. Not the best chain off, an Income Scandal, Battery Assault. They are able to get that kill, but with Spectre ulting down, and the Fiend's Grip over to the Alchemist. Stomper will come up. He's able to steal the Fiend's Grip. I'm not quite sure if he'll live through this, however. The Nyx Stun gives him some space, but Scandal now ulti coming off cooldown, so they can chase down Stomper. The Dagger as well, yes, they do pick him up before he can even use that Bane ulti. And then Azizu behind the Tier 1 tower in the bottom lane.
Yeah, this is really unfortunate just because of the fact they have to have a heavy amount of numbers whenever they go in for these ganks because they have such good single target disable up on Empire. You've got the Clockwork being able to jump in from so far away and be able to lock down one or two heroes inside of his cogs. You've got the Bane with the Sleep, the Enfeeble, and his ultimate being able to come in. You even throw down small things like Furion's going to be able to pick up, you know, that Scythe of Ice eventually. They really have to play the numbers game soon.
This is a lot of support coming in. Scandal's cogs are already going to screw with the Alchemist. The second he arrived, you'll get a quick Concoction Sun over to the Visage, but it's only a quick one. Visage still got a full set of Soul Assumption charges. He's going to lose them all right now, though. Jotam coming in behind. Starts off with attack, the general attack with the Breathe Fire. Able to get rid of Visage in Light of Heaven, hides himself in his own tree line, so he can TP out to safety. Realizing it's just not worth staying on this lane anymore. And Blow Your Brain doesn't want a part of this. They're actually sacrificing the T1 tower. They're happy to let it go here.
Yeah, absolutely. Losing a hero like that, even though it's a small support hero, on top of that, Spectre doesn't have his ultimate, so if he did, they would maybe consider just trying to delay the push, and then if they finally initiated, they just pop the Spectre ultimate. But since Spectre can't be there, it's going to be a no-go. And they're just going to try and farm up where they can, which is obviously everywhere when they have a Furion. Mm-hmm. He is going to be able to pick up that Scythe of Ice very, very soon. And that's really, really important for him to pick it up early because of the fact you have a Nyx Assassin on the other team. You also have that Dragonite who could potentially pick up a Scythe of Ice as well as the Alchemist. You have a bunch of Invis heroes who'd love to be able to pick on some of those squishy heroes like Furion who have no escape mechanism besides that sort of slow teleport. So if they can get that initiation, the little bit of damage, physical damage coming out from the Shadow Blade, follow up with their stuns, that should be very, very easy kills when Furion tries to split push. Mm-hmm.
Be fast with it, man. Is this now Empire smoked up? I thought for a moment they might be looking over towards Roshan, but they'll come underneath the Radiant Observer Ward. No sentry with it, though, so they don't know what's going on here. But it's a three-man gang squad with the two birds to boot. And they'll look over towards the middle lane. Stomper and Shafiq, they're the two that are there. They could find the Alchemist a little bit further down, but they'll have to dive in a little bit too deep for their liking. They just look towards the Tier 1 and the Tier 2 tower in the bottom lane. Tier 1 tower just taken out by Light of Heaven. So he's got his Shadow Blade already now. Courier's flying out to him. But Empire still want to go for this mid. That Radiant Observer Ward has spotted them. So they know what's coming. And that's why Alchemist already into the Chemical Rage. Sentry Wards are down. No Invis. They throw down the Dire Sentry Ward too. They've got the Vision of the Alchemist. That Fiend's Grip, shortest duration of ever. Shafiq hardly even control, but they've already killed off the Alchemist. Bane will be the Sacrificial Lamb for this one with a Soul Assumption. Stomper gets completely nuked out. Scandal is right behind John. Another Soul Assumption as well. One last attack from the Visage. It's going to be enough. Ends the killing spree. The double kill from Sunlight in the middle of that fight, but it's still a 3-for-1. It's about to be a 3-for-3 after Zizu comes in, snipes out that Visage. Blow Your Brain, insanely lucky to escape, but in the meantime, Light of Heaven doing what Light of Heaven does, and that's completely ignore everything that happens on the map, and just take towers.
Yeah, that could have been such a better fight. Blow Your Brain got out with 2 health from that acid spray. Unbelievable that he was able to escape. Some double damage is going to be picked up by Sharfeet, but still, they're going to have just such a hard time dealing with this split push. They need to be able to get a gank on him from the Nyx Assassin, one of these Shadow Blade heroes, something like that. That way they could just put a little bit of fear on into Light of Heaven. You just continue to push aggressively when you play some of these split push heroes. You just push really, really aggressively until they punish you. And when they punish you, okay, that's fine. You back up. You play a little bit more passive. But it's always worth it to push extremely aggressively like this, especially if you've got a hard carry. You direct a lot of attention your way. And if they never successfully get a kill off on you, they're wasting a lot of time. So until they punish Light of Heaven, he's just going to continue to threaten those tier twos.
Mm-hmm. Actually, I don't even think punishing Light of Heaven's going to stop him, man. This is Light of Heaven we're talking about.
Yeah, that's true.
He doesn't stop, man. You kill him once, he'll just go again and force you to waste more time trying to kill him. And in the meantime, then Spectre will get the farm that Blow Your Brain requires. He's sitting at 2,500 gold right now after building into a drums, building into treads, having a poor man's shield. You know he's going to be going straight in for that Radiance. Diffuser Blade will be an option for him, but more than likely he'll be searching for the Radiance. That way he can deal with heroes like this Nyx Assassin so easily. Rubick as well. Just throw that ulti out and they'll both be down to half of their life points very, very quickly. And that's why you're already feeling the Radiance side. They know the clock is ticking. They're going to push in through this Tier 2 tower as fast as they possibly can. Look to the Tier 3 towers. Well, Blow Your Brain wants to get a trade-off. It's a Tier 1 tower in the mid and the Tier 1 tower on the top lane, but already now entering the base with a DD up on the DK. There's no fortification. Empire is forced to come back right now. They can leave the creep waves to finish off the job, but they must hold this bottom. FNG, Nightmare up on the Alchemist. Now Prophet Sprout caught out Shafiq as well as shot him. Spectre gonna ulti Sunlight. He's so low in life and does go down to DK's last attack there. The question is, how much collateral damage will there be for this push? And Scandal wants to make sure Shafiq is part of the casualties, and he gets it too. Blow Your Brain actually going on a mega kill streak right now, as they want to search for the Alchemist. They saw him move up high. Scandal picked up the Weaver, and now the TP out. They've got nothing to disable him. Not in time, at least. So four heroes lost for the price of, what was that? One for Team Empire, and two Tier 1 towers for a Tier 2 tower, and almost a full Tier 3 as well. 17 life points on that little sucker. And they're going in for Roshan as well.
Yeah, I mean, I was looking pretty risky there for Team Empire, allowing so much damage to go on the tower. FR just did not back up. The moment they saw those teleports, and then they looked in top lane, and the creeps were giving vision of teleports, they should have immediately backed up. They did a lot of damage to the tier 3. Just accept that and back up. And I think they're relying on their double damage a little bit too much. But Dragonite doesn't have his BKB yet. If he had his BKB, that would have been a completely different fight. He would have used that double damage much more effectively. Would have been able to kill maybe the Visage Birds. The Visage himself definitely would have gone down much sooner. And that could have been a much better fight. But unless they have those core items, they can't really force a fight in a tier 3 like that.
Mm-hmm.
So they really paid the price for that one. And
it's a big price.
Well, I thought
too,
for a second. Yeah. That's 5,000 gold lead now.
I'm actually talking about the bigger price being Blow Your Brain. I don't know if you saw it with Team Empire, but at the very, very last moment, they stopped everything from attacking Roshan so Blow Your Brain could finish the job. And he got enough money out of that one to sell one item and then pick up his full Radiance.
Nice.
And that was the big thing, because he was going to be short by at least another 300, 400 gold if they didn't do that. So they get the timing right for that one. Prophet basically now has his Orchid as well. So from this fight, from that Roshan, they're getting so much money. Not to mention, of course, the Aegis the Immortal up on the Spectre.
Yeah, and with that very early Radiance now, they can still rely on their BKBs. But honestly, before that team fight, I was concerned about going that early Radiance just because you have some tanky heroes being picked up on Dragonite and the Alchemist. They have some good lockdown. There's no reason they can't just cleave through all of Spectre's health. I mean, Spectre is not the tankiest hero in the world unless you actually build some stat items. You're relying purely on dispersion. But besides
Alchemist
dispersion,
is dead. Fiend's Grip will go. They put the Sprout down as well. Scandal's coming in nice and close as well. He doesn't really need to land anything. Clockwork, able to get the last little right swing in. Walking in with now his Blade Mail up and running. And Blow Your Brain, he's already starting to burn out the Juggernaut, the DK. Stomper will steal Spectral Dagger. I suppose that's going to be something, but Blow Your Brain doesn't care at this point. He knows that Tier 2 tower will now go down the bottom lane because the momentum pushing through there is high enough, especially with the Alchemist dead. And Alchemist spent all of his money before he died, too. He was trying to buy into that BKB of his. Just trying to protect his cash. But because of this now, he cannot be alive to defend any of these out of positions.
Yeah, I think they realize that It's just too late. It's just too late for them. That last team fight was really crucial, and the fact that they fed that Radiance into the Spectre, they can no longer force these early team fights and try and come out ahead. So now they're just going to have to rely on their three cores and trying to get some damage items up on the Weaver. Alchemist is working on his BKB, and then Dragonite, I don't know what he's going to be going next, but...
For DK, it's kind of like this blend of life or damage. For me, what I would hope he'd be doing is trying to get himself up to level 16, number one priority, and second priority, having that extra damage that goes with a splash. Even if it's just a Crystallis, a little bit more of a cheaper item he can afford rather early, and then you got the Daedalus that can fly up if you're able to get yourself ahead during one of these team fights. So for me, that would be the bigger thing I'd like to see up on him. But at the same time, he needs to maneuver a lot better too, so maybe Shadow Blade may not be a bad choice as well, but that means he becomes the initiator, where he kind of wants Nyx Assassin to be doing that.
Yeah, I don't think you can really go Shadow Blades this late. They already have the one up on Alchemist, and they haven't really used it effectively. As Jotam goes down at top, that Orchid coming into play.
Didn't even have to use the ulti for that one, too. And then let's see what's up on Bane. With a gem now up. Yeah, you're right, they cannot go Shadow Blades. Weaver and a Shadow Blade. One gem, as long as they can keep that alive on FNG, they're good to go. At least it's on FNG. I say at least. He's the one with 1.1k, almost 1.2k life points on him, plus the Brain Sap, which instantly gives him 300 life points back again. Yeah. And he's already on the hunt. Smokes up. There's a walk around with the gem. He's looking to see if anyone's going to try and go on Scandal and throws down the ward when he sees no one else is. Oh, a Light of Heaven as pressure towards the top lane again. And that's now going to be Nyx Assassin. They can see him quite clearly and then instantly into the Fiend's Grip. And they combine up with the Orchid. Spectre now going to haunt in. We'll see Shafiq, the back end Stomper, actually burning in this one. Scandal going to ulti himself in, up into the Blade Mouth, almost asking Alchemist to attack him. Then the four-star, so he says no more attacking. Light of Heaven, now Fiend's Gripped up. Stolen there by the Rubik. FNG will follow through directly after, which means the gem is down the deck and Blow Your Brain being beaten down by the Alchemist. The Familiars trying to as much damage as they possibly can. Light of Heaven fires back. So in the combination of the Orchid plus the Soul Assumption, they're able to get that kill. It costs them buybacks, costs them Aegis the Immortal. At this point, it's kind of a worthy sacrifice for what they will claim in return, which will be a tier 2 and possibly even a tier 3 tower.
Yeah, absolutely. This is looking to be Empire. They're going to try and finish the game now. They know that Dragonite, Alchemist, and Weaver can all have a lot of room to grow, and they can start building some damage going to late game, so they're just going to try and put the pressure in that they have now. They don't necessarily have to go straight for the throat. If FR is able to defend their racks here, they can wait until the next Roshan, pick up that other Aegis, and then just attempt another push. Mm-hmm.
What a beautiful ability for Rubik to steal. We got level 8 Rubik with level 3 Wrath of Nature. That does more damage than any of his abilities, any damage that he could possibly deal during a team fight. That one ability does it all for him. It's a shame if he stole Spectre's ulti, he wouldn't get the Radiance effect as well. the most Spectre's... powerful Rubik.
Yeah. Spectre's going to start building into some health now. He knows he's a bit squishy. And once he has that hard, pretty much he's unstoppable for a really long time.
Actually, it looks like a casual Vitality Booster because he just bought a Yasha. I suppose you still got the ultimate orb point, so that's health. That's health. Illusion. Not to mention he has to like buff himself up, goes from 9 to 11 armor. Drastic change. Putting all that agility to work, man.
Yeah,
we got Fake Bane's coming in the bottom lane too. Looks like he's either building into a 4-star right now, or he could be considering the Dagon. Right now he's pooling in a lot of TPs, and we've got a full mech coming out. Couldn't have been at a better time. But notice where Team Empire are going. Like, they're coming in through the bottom lane now. Like, the top lane Rax is exposed, but they want to assault through a tier 3 tower in the bottom lane. They've got the Radiant Jungle available to them there. But still, interesting choice.
Oops. Well, they're going to push in tier 3. I mean, at the very least, they're going to sit in front of this bottom lane while Spectre is allowed to just keep on going. Spectre doesn't have buyback, so this would be a really good opportunity for FR. They have to make something happen right now, so if they, like, get a smoke up and just try and go for the gank on Spectre and pop her, that could give them a lot of room to be able to farm up, push out these lanes again. Otherwise, they're just going to get locked inside their base, and you're going to see Spectre all over the map farming, you know, jungle, farming two different lanes. And whenever they need him, he's just going to be able to be there with his ultimate. So I really think they need to make something happen, some sort of gank on the Spectre or the Furion. A Furion's another good target.
And they both find themselves directly next to each other, and you never want to gank them both together. Solos only, peoples. No two-man dance. At least Shafiq now. So we see what he's building into. He's going to go for Heaven's Halberd, either that or it's going to be an S and Y. But I'd go for the Halberd. They need some higher level of control during this.
Yeah.
No BKB.
And the evasion is really good as well. So, evasion will help out versus the Spectre, and then also being able to disable him is huge. And also, I think I said the wrong thing yesterday. Someone sent me a tweet. The recent patch went ahead and changed, you can no longer Manta.
Oh, you might have to wait a second, man. BKB, yep, they're backing out. Oh. You can keep on going. That BKB is on cooldown for the moment. That may be an opportunity for him.
Yeah, they could choose to push in now, but Manta doesn't stop Heaven's Halberd now. So, even when Spectre does have that, they get the Heaven's Halberd on him, it won't matter. Manta won't be able to dispel that.
Okay.
So.
Correction one to capitalist.
Mm-hmm.
That's why we look for the people to tweet us out information. Sometimes commentators don't always get it right. Get those familiars down. See Shafiq, in fact, just resummons them. He knows he's going to lose them, and Scandal jumps in with his ultimate. Spectre going to haunt in as well. The mat, that burn. Look at Stomper's life points. They're just disappearing so quickly. He has to go back to heal, but they don't get a kill with this. Light of Heaven also wasn't getting himself involved. Light of Heaven wants to finish up the Daedalus the DK can't complete. Yeah. But definitely tweet us out, like, anything. Would you ever think something is interesting? We actually want to know, too. TobiWan, DOTA?
I remember when that patch change came, I was like, yes, that was needed. I remember reading that, too, and going, this was needed, Heaven's Halberd. Getting dispelled by that was just too strong. Manta's just a consistent pickup item for so many carries and makes Halberd kind of useless.
Oh, FNG. It is so good he had an invis rune. He just revealed the smoke gank that was coming in at the exact same time as Roshan spawns. One stun goes over on Sunlight Dota, the Fiend's Grip. Well, it tried to go. Now Clockwork has to latch in, but they've already lost their Baim this fight. The BKBs both popping off. Both the Alchemist as well as the DK. Getting very, very big, blow your brain. Still getting stunned up, but doesn't stop that Radiance burn. And he's right on the back of Shafiq with the support from Light of Heaven. The burn does the job. Roshan's still up. The Sprout goes down. It holds the Alchemist in position up to grab himself a long stun up on Scandal as well as Light of Heaven. But they've still got this extra vision. So blow your brain picks himself up a double kill. And they're looking for Jotam. Who's the one with the gem? It's in the hands of Sunlight, who also picks up the kill on the Weaver. The entire team of the Radiant side on the sidelines. Roshan's available as well. They create the army of trees, and they'll go back in here. And with an Aegis, you can almost guarantee that one of these racks will go down.
Yeah, absolutely. This is pretty much, this is pretty much Empire complete control of the game, and they shouldn't really lose this. Like the idea of the whole three core lineup is the fact that they would be able to perform in the mid game really, really strong and force some fights, take some early towers, and they would get a gold advantage off of that, and they were supposed to just continue to build even once Spectre did get that Radiance. They still had the damage to take him down, and they would just continue to constantly build a gold advantage, and once you start getting into 45, 55 minutes in, they all have a significant amount of items, and they're all doing some really good damage, but here, it doesn't even matter because they're not getting any extra farm. Like, you're not seeing any new big items being picked up by these heroes. It's a very, very slow process of them building into that extra damage. And at this point in time, it's going to take, you know, 70, 80 minutes in before they actually have any real damage. And Spectre is going to be completely maxed out by that point.
Mm-hmm. Jotam could be really careful right now. He is so lucky that FNG didn't get enough money to buy up a Blink Dagger. And said that he went for the Staff of Wizardry. But Light of Heaven, man, he's now doing 700, 650 damage. with every single hit when he goes for that crit through the Daedalus. And with this is 32 minutes in from the support Nature's Prophet, who can also Orchid you too, so you've already got the Amplifier that will come through that. Prophet will bounce through, Rock gives a little bit of extra deeper vision. Well, Light of Heaven says we're not going to instantly break this bottom tower. So let me push out the top while Blow Your Brain takes the tier 2 tower in the mid. Still got the Aegis on him, but the Heaven's Halberd will finally finish up on Shafiq. So they got at least a small advantage coming from that. And the tower does go down the middle lane. So more money for Blow Your Brain.
And they're in no rush. They're in absolutely no rush. They're just slowly pushing in. Furion's going to push in this top lane and start putting some pressure there. They're just going to keep bouncing around and doing little chips of damage to these towers. And eventually that's going to be them doing chips of damage to the Rax as well. So Mantis Tau picked up on the Spectre, and I'm presuming now we're going to see a Heart, but he could build for even more damage. Honestly, with 2100 health and the Aegis, he doesn't necessarily have to worry about getting popped, especially since FR hasn't been able to take the next step in their damage items. Appear not to be focusing Spectre in those team fights. Like, that last team fight was just Spectre running around auto-attacking everyone.
Yeah.
No, like,
who were they focusing for that one? It seems like we split ourselves into three. It's just the supports.
Yeah.
But Sunlight was staying alive for the entire time as well. Like, you want to try and bring him down? He's walking around with a point boost or a full mech. And you got to remember the effect of the Gravekeeper's Cloak as well. And now there's your Fiend Script. DK being brought down. Look at Sunlight's Soul Assumption charges start to build on this one. He's straight back up to full Soul Assumption charge with this fight. And the Prophet only bouncing through as well. Weaver's going to die at the back. There goes the Alchemist. It's a triple kill for Blow Your Brain. And it's probably going to become an Ultra Scandal. Best ulti of his life. And there's GG. That's going to be a 34-minute GG. This is, however, a best-of-three matchup. So it's not over just yet. But if Team Empire do take it out 2-0, they'll advance themselves through into the next round. We've got more matches as well coming up for you tonight, guys. After this, we'll be jumping ourselves over to Fnatic. So Fnatic versus SN is going to be the choice of match at the conclusion of this one. We do have a bit of a delay start for four of the other matches, starting at 20:30, so 8:30 here on CEST time. So then we'll follow through to the victors of that one. If predictions are correct, then our round two, last best of three matchup will be Fnatic going up against Lion's Pride, and that'll cap up our day. So, fun times all round coming your way. Hopefully you'll stay tuned as we'll enjoy the action. So yeah, we'll be back here in a couple of moments time, guys. See you shortly.